Anthony?
Hey, Georgia.
You okay?
Honestly, I've been kind of struggling to figure out how to write out the back end for my code. And, like, my friend Walter told me that I should use Ruby for it, but I don't know Ruby, and the syntax is weird, and I don't know what I'm doing, and...
Okay. Let's just take a step back and realize that you've come a long way. You're in your strain zone right now, but that's okay. So, just tell me a little bit about what you're doing.
So, I'm trying to build out a class for a database so that I can store images.
Okay. So, you've learned about classes in Python, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's just put Project Compass aside for a minute and look at an example of a class, okay? So here's a class in Python for a car object. Can you explain that to me?
Yeah, so it's got a couple of attributes, year, make, and model. And I see, like, down here we have this new car that's a new car object with some of these attributes defined.
Okay, great. So let's look at what this looks like in Ruby. So as you can see, there are a couple of differences. In Python, you would have to declare self. But in Ruby, you don't have to do that. Also, when you create a new instance of a variable, you actually need the keyword .new, but in Python, you don't. But other than that, the logic is pretty much the same.
OK, I see how they're similar. How can I learn more about these syntax differences?
So you can check out the Ruby documentation online, or you can check out online forums, because there's a huge community to help new programmers. In addition, check out the Udacity forums. That'll be really helpful to you.
OK. I'll give it another shot. Thanks, Georgia.
You can do it, Anthony. I believe in you.